Hi everyone. Firstly, we want to download both rainfall and temperature data. In Google Chrome, head over to www.ncdc.noaa.gov. The URL is right here. Some information about this website. It is the National Oceanic Atmospheric Administration's, or NOAA, National Centers for Environmental Information, or NCEI. NOAA's NCEI is responsible for hosting this website here is responsible for hosting and providing access to one of the most significant archives on Earth, with access to national and global oceanic, atmospheric, and geophysical data sets. NCEI's climate data are used in many applications, including agriculture, construction, engineering, education, and energy. So let's begin by downloading climatology data. Let's begin by clicking on the data access tab located at the top of the page here. We want land-based station data. So scroll down and click on this link here. This page sort of tells you about the land-based station data, information about that, how it's being recorded, information's being recorded. And so what we want from this page is the find a station. All right, so here is the find a station where we want to both rainfall and temperature data. We begin by entering in this box here, the location or the region or the state even, where we want climate data from. So since we are in Hawaii, I will type in Haleakala. This is where I've done some climatological research myself. And in the select data set drop-down menu, we want to look at the global summary of the month. So let's click on that. Now, when we look at the climatology of a region, we're usually looking at the average climate of 30 or year more or more years worth of data. So in this select date range drop-down menu, that's where we will select 30 years worth of data. So scroll down all the way to 1988, January 1st. We have to select the specific date, all the way to 2017, December 31st. Right? We're not going to go all the way to 2018 because we want 2017, and we want that to be a full year worth of data. Hit the apply button, and in the data categories, we will select both air temperature and precipitation. Now, when you're selecting these options here, the interactive map on the right sort of updates to provide you with such data. And here we are looking at Haleakala. And there are three stations near the area, right? And so select one. If you already know the station you want, that's great. I will select this one. Now, once you select that station, it'll show some brief information about the station, and we want to add to cart, just like we're shopping online. Now, all the data is free. You don't have to purchase anything. It doesn't require any money, which is great. Now, let's check out. So this orange button here with the cart, one item, select that. This is the checkout site, and so the select the output format, we want to select a CSV file because we want to manipulate the data. We want to change columns or maybe even rows. And a CSV file will allow us to do that. So click on that. In the select the date range, that is correct, right? 30 years worth of data from 1988 to 2017. Review the item in this cart. It shows a station that I've chosen, and we will click on continue. All right, so station detail on the CSV file, it'll have the station name, and in standard units. Both rainfall and temperature will be in standard units. Now again, we have to select the data types for this outcome, for this custom output. We will select the plus icon next to the precipitation, which includes the rainfall data. Select precipitation there and select the plus icon for air temperature and select average temperature. So we'll have two variables, both precipitation and air temperature, in our CSV file. Now we select continue. And lastly, this is the review page, right? It just tells you what type of data set that you are ordering, the start date, the end date, the output, which is a CSV file, both precipitation and temperature, and the station. Now here we will enter our email address two times. I already have mine inputted. And lastly, we click on the submit order. All right, that's how you download station data. Now, when you log on to your email address, you should receive an email, a confirmation email, with, again, this type of the order information. And then a few minutes later, you should receive another email with a download link to the CSV file. And you can download that straight to your computer, and you have access to both temperature and rainfall data.